Okay, so here's the wireframe for the authentication flow, which is really simple. They just put in their username or their email, right? They need a strong password to protect their data. So they have capital letters, numbers, punctuation, basic stuff. Minimum length of password, no usernames, can't have them the same. They have no common words. If they get it wrong, a big red X, they get it right, they get a nice green tick right there, and then they log in. Simple.
Why don't we use Smart Lock?
Hi, I'm Eiji. Let me show you what is Smart Lock. Smart Lock makes authenticating into devices, websites, and apps easier, faster, and more secure. Among other Smart Lock features, Smart Lock for Passwords unlock your websites and apps using passwords stored in the cloud when Chrome or Android is signed in with a Google account. Let's have a closer look at how it works. Let's say you operate a website that uses usernames and passwords to authenticate users. Once a user is signed into your website on Chrome, Smart Lock can save the credentials for your user, so they don't need to remember their password next time they visit your site using Chrome. And because Smart Lock syncs to the cloud, the user's credentials to your site are available on other devices. It's worked this way across devices in Chrome for some time, but today, saved credentials are also available to the apps on the user's Android devices. This means that Smart Lock-enabled apps can now retrieve the user's saved credential information and automatically sign in the user. This also works in reverse. If a user starts with authenticating on your Android app, your website can also retrieve the user's credential information. So let's take a closer look how you can enable Smart Lock for Passwords on your Android app. Before you start coding, make sure you have added Google Play Services revision 23 or later as a dependency. The first thing you should do is to retrieve the user's password. In order to do that, call Auth Credentials API request. By instantiating a credential request and call set support password login, you can query username and password required to authenticate a user. Note that by calling set account types, you can query federated logins as well. The result will be returned as a callback with a credential request result as the argument. By calling getStatus, you can get its status. If the status indicates success, that means there's only one credential information associated with the Google account. In that case, call getCredential to obtain actual credential information and proceed with signing in the user. Otherwise, let the user manually sign in and save the credential information. In order to save the credential information, call Auth Credentials API save. Saved credential information can be created by instantiating a credential object, then calling setPassword. If you're running a web version of the same app, make sure to link the domain to your app. In order to do that, verify the domain using Google Search Console, then link your app to the domain using Google Play Developer Console. Smart Lock for Passwords removes friction from your existing authentication system by automatically signing in users across devices. Once your user saves a password to Smart Lock, they can skip entering their credentials to access your app or site on all of their Chrome and Android devices. We are working on Smart Lock for Passwords APIs on other platforms too. To keep updated and learn more about Smart Lock for Passwords, head over to this document. I'm looking forward to seeing you develop apps that are personalized yet low friction.
Simple.